lookup functions. I'm sure at least once or twice you might have used the lookup functions in Excel, because the Excel, one of the very important category of the functions are the lookup category. There are two types of lookup functions we have. Rather, three types. There are two types of lookup functions we have. Lookup functions. One is VLOOKUP. V means vertical. Second one, HLOOKUP. H means horizontal. What is the meaning? What is the relevance of vertical and horizontal? In case the master data is in vertical order, then we use VLOOKUP function. In case the master data is in horizontal order, then we use a good morning, Vinath. Just now I started, just 1 minute back. Then we use HLOOKUP function, right? So this is the relevance of VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. There is a XLOOKUP which introduced. XLOOKUP introduced in September 2019, which overcomes the limitations in VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. I'll talk about this little later. Anyway, if you want to have this, you must have the latest Office 365 Insider version, right? XLOOKUP introduced in September. Now let us concentrate more into the VLOOKUP function and HLOOKUP function. What is VLOOKUP function? Okay, where we use this? VLOOKUP function looks for a value. Okay, that means, Sharon, if you want to look for a value, where in the leftmost column of the table, in the leftmost column of the table, that means I should give first argument what value I am looking for, second one I should give in which column I should look for, in which table I should look for, and so on. Let us take this example. Now here I have product ID I want to get. Okay, sorry. Product ID is already there. I want to get product subcategory and product category. For example, this is what the master data I have. Let's say this is the master data. To make it simple, can I have a defined name for that? Yes. Can I have V table? Yes. V table, that means vertical table. Now out of this, probably I am looking for this, then I am looking for this, then I am looking for randomly this. I want to get the result for this, I want to get final result for this, and last one I want to get the result 20, this one is 2. Okay. This is what the master data I have, in which I have the data for every product ID, product category, and subcategory. Now, out of which I'm doing some analysis. I want to get the product subcategory for all these product IDs, and okay, I want to get the sub product category also. If you don't have a function like a VLOOKUP function or HLOOKUP, what we do? We'll copy this data, we'll look into this column where it is. If it is available, the respective value we'll copy and we'll go and we'll paste here. Okay, this is the manual job. Instead, we have a great function's name, VLOOKUP function. So looks for a value, in the leftmost column of the table, and then what it returns? And then returns a value. That means my result is always a value. That can be any value. Okay. And then returns a value in the same row from a column we specify. From a column number we specify. Okay. Very important. I'm just trying to put this sentence so that you will get to know what are the arguments. Right. So looks for a value. First argument in this VLOOKUP function must be the lookup value. Second argument, you have to look that value in the table. That means the entire table is the second argument. What is the third argument? It will look into the same row from a column number we specify. That means column number is also important. Now let me start writing the formula equal to VLOOKUP. Exactly the same description I have written. If you observe, looks for a value in the leftmost column of the table and then returns a value in the same row from a column you specify. VLOOKUP. What is the first argument? I want to look this. Where in VTable column, comma. Now, let us try to understand the recipe of VLOOKUP function, how it works. It takes this value. It will look into where only in the leftmost column of the table, where it has given, in the description it has given, looks for a value in the leftmost column of the table. So it will look into this column. It identify wherever prod 6 is there. That entire row it will extract out. Now Excel is doing at the back end, it is extracting the row of prod 6. Now out of this row, what it has to display, whatever the column number which I specify. So in the row of prod 6 office supplies paper, my answer for subcategory is into which column? Third column. So what I need to do, I should give the third column number. If you observe, it's a column index number, comma. If you observe, fourth argument is optional. How do you know that? It is there in the square bracket. That means I can either ignore the fourth argument or I can even enter the fourth argument. If you ignore the fourth argument, what will happen? By default, it takes the approximate match. Approximate match will not work for the text items. So in case of text, I always keep the zero. That's an exact match. Okay, don't confuse. Looks for this value in this table and get the third column value, and which is an exact match. Absolutely. Once you copy this, why in this case I got an error? Because it is not available, right? So can I write the formula for product category? VLOOKUP. Why I'm writing the V first of all? Because my data is there in the vertical shape. Look for this value. Where in this table? Okay, this table name is automatically coming, V table, comma. Which column value I want to get as an answer now? Second column value, because my product category is there in the second column of the table, comma, zero, close bracket. Copy, paste special, copy and paste below. Okay, now if you observe, VLOOKUP is having limitations. What are the limitations? Can anyone tell? The limitations in the description itself, it is saying it always look into the leftmost column. VLOOKUP always looks into the leftmost column. Means if the lookup value is not in the leftmost column, but in the right side. Then VLOOKUP will not work. One more limitation is there. What is that limitation? For example, product 6 is there, it has taken half his supplies. Let's say this is also product 6. It's not product 8. Let's say this is also product 6. Now you tell me whether it takes this one or this one. It always takes the first one. So, duplicate values in case of duplicate values in the lookup column, in the leftmost column, VLOOKUP considers the first column only. There is a, it makes sense for this rule because you are looking into the master data. Master data means which may have the primary key. Primary key should not be a duplicate. When there is a duplicate, that means we should doubt the quality of this data. Okay. So ideally that should not be possible. Okay. If any case of duplicate, then it will not work. It always takes the first value. These all are the two limitations of the VLOOKUP function. Again, let me write the formula for all of you. Product subcategory equal to VLOOKUP. Look for this value where within this table, get the third column value as an exact match. If you observe this last argument, same even in the case of match function. But here I'll take the same lookup value. But here I'm taking the table because my answer also I should select. But in that case, match function, I always take the one column or one row. Then third argument is not there in the match function. Fourth argument is exact match or approximate match. Enter. Copy paste. Let me take the same formula equal to VLOOKUP. Look for this value where V table get the second column value as an answer. Okay. If anyone having any question, please let me know. Now, for example, in case if the table is horizontal like this, how to convert the vertical table into horizontal? We copy, paste special, transpose. Are you finding we have an option here? Transpose is the feature which can convert your rows into columns and columns into rows. Right? Friends, I have a question. If I go and change this value, let's say, let me change here to 6. Do you think this value will change even here? No. See, this is the example. If you change here, it has not changed here automatically. So what happened here? When I am trying to do copy and paste special transpose, it will not give you the link. It will take it as an absolute values. Either you can copy paste special transpose, or else there is an alternative. You can even use the function names transpose. In Excel, there is a function names transpose. Transpose V table. If you observe, the result of the V table is not just one cell, it's having hundreds of cells. Okay, in this case, it's having 18 columns, 18 rows and 3 columns. Transpose is by default an array formula. Okay, array formula, how I need to enter? Because I have already selected the area, control, shift, enter. Now you go and change this value will change automatically because it is no more a feature, now it become a formula. Try to understand, I'm just quickly covering again. What I'm trying to do, if I want to get my vertical data into this shape, where vertical should come as a horizontal and horizontal should come as a vertical, I'll take the function names transpose. Transpose, there is a feature, there is a function also. Now, I want to convert V table. As I told you already about the arrays, the result of this may be more than one cell. How can I fit more than one cell into a range? Select that area and do Control Shift Enter because I want to enter this as an array operation. Now, friends, this is what VLOOKUP, right? Now I want to take the example for the H lookup function. Everyone please concentrate. Now let me remove this. Yeah. Okay. Now friends. Yeah. Now I want to take the data from this. Do we have to select 3 rows and 18 columns? Yes. I'll tell you. Now what I do to make it more simple and to make it more easy to understand, I'll select this. I'll give my defined names as H table. Okay. So that this is a horizontal table. Wherever there is a reference to this range, I'll just put as a H table. Now equal to. Now I want to get my result from this table. Now this is horizontally arranged. I should use H lookup function. What is the first argument? Same lookup value. Where in H table, in this table, which row value I should get as an answer? It is first, second, third row because it's subcategory. 1, 2, 3. 3, comma, since it's an exact match 0. Friends, the difference between VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP function is there we are looking into the columns. Here we are looking into the rows. There we are giving the column index number. Here we are giving the row index number. That's all. Now again, let me write the formula for product category. HLOOKUP, look for this value where in this table, get me the second row value as an answer. Absolutely enter. So you will get the product category. Vinath, I think your question got answered now. Right? Great. So that's the way it's happening. Now what we'll do, we'll try to play with. Okay, let's take the heading properly so that you can understand. This is HLOOKUP. This is VLOOKUP. Now I have a question. By using this data, can I use the VLOOKUP function instead of HLOOKUP? I hope you get my point. I want to use VLOOKUP, but I want to use the data which is there in the H table. Simple, equal to VLOOKUP, look for this value where in the H table, but Excel will not give you the answer. Why? Because it's a horizontal table you are using in the VLOOKUP function. So what I'll do, I'll put the transpose for H table directly, comma, 3rd column, comma, 0. Because transpose is by default an array formula, you should do Control Shift Enter. Now, just copy paste. Now, you tell me the formula VLOOKUP, look for this value, transpose of HLOOKUP, transpose of H table, close bracket, comma, I want to get second column value. As an answer, don't enter because transpose is by default an array formula. I should do Control Shift Enter, copy and paste. Or else, can I do the same thing by using HLOOKUP, by using this V table? Can you put the formula in the chat box? I want to use the HLOOKUP. But I want to use vertical table as the reference. Now, what is the formula I should write? Equal to HLOOKUP. Look for this value where in the V table, but V table is a vertical. I'm writing the HLOOKUP. Transpose of V table. But selecting number of column increase the job. I'll come to your point. I want to get the third column as an answer, close bracket, Control Shift Enter, just copy paste. In here, H lookup, look for this value where in the H table, sorry, V table I want to select. So transpose of V table, close bracket, comma, second column I want to answer. So that's all. Friends, don't confuse. Same thing. In case of VLOOKUP, I need to take the vertical table. Let's say if vertical table is not possible, but still I want to use the VLOOKUP function, then I'm going to take transpose. So exactly. Now let's come back to the question by Vinat. There may be problem for large data. Why? Counting the column number? No, I'll tell you the easy method to do the job. For example, I know your question. For example, I have a student ID, then student name, then student city, and so on. There may be a chance that we may even have 100 columns. Yes or no? Right, now what I'm going to do? Let's say there is a data even in these columns also. Let us assume that there is a data even in these columns also. Now, ID 1 is there, 2 is there, 3 is there, 4 is there. Then there is some names A, B, C, D. Then from there are so many values are here. Now, for example, let's say H, A, C, D. Okay. Now, if I want to get ID number 3, what is the city? Equal to VLOOKUP. Look for this value. Where? Now, just observe, Vinat. When I select this, are you finding at the corner the array? Now, I'm selecting 43 columns. Now, you need to take comma 43, comma 0. But I do understand your point. Okay, your question is valid. Let's say I want to select this entire table, but I want to get this column, jet column. Then I need to count the column. There is no doubt. That's the reason most of the cases, while people writing the VLOOKUP function, they'll put the column number 1, 2, 3, and so on. They'll keep on drag till the end so that they'll check it out this on the top. Oops. Okay. Oops. Why? Yeah, let me select this. I hope, Vinat, your question got answered. There are two ways. If you are trying to take the last column or only the column till where you want to select, at the corner you are having, while you are selecting at the corner, you are having a matrix. There you can see which column number. If not, maybe there is a situation where out of the bigger table, transposing to vertical. Oh, okay, I got your point. So you are saying, if you want to convert this into word horizontal, I got your question. If I copy this, if I wanna select this first, I need to select this. This is what you were saying. You may be saying, exactly how can I select that range? In those cases, I use a small technique, Vinat. Just have a look. Now, I copy that. First, I'll paste special transpose automatically. It got selected everywhere already. Now, I'll delete this data. Now, I'll use transpose. You got my technique? Wherever I want to write a transpose formula, first I'll do copy paste special transpose. Then entirely my data got selected. Now I'll delete the data. Then I'll use a transpose function. Okay. That's the small technique. Now let's try to look into a couple of remarks of, H lookup. Let me quickly cover the theory so that you can understand. Exactly the same thing for HLOOKUP. It will look for a value in the not leftmost column of the table. It look into the topmost row of the table and then it returns a value in the same column from a row you specify. Row number we specify. Okay, once transposing do the same job, then why we are writing formulas again? No, no, I'm just giving you different combination of the formulas, Vinat. Okay, it's not required. If you already have the data into horizontal format, you can directly write a H lookup. There is no need of V lookup. Just for practicing the formulas, I'm giving you different options. Oh, you're talking about transpose feature. Once we use copy paste special transpose, why we need to have a transpose function, is it? Is it your question? I told you, right? If you do the copy paste special transpose, if you change your original data, this data will not change because it's a feature. But if you write a formula, let me explain. For example, here I have, you got it? Great. So now the same limitations are there even for HLOOKUP function also. Let me copy this and paste here. HLOOKUP always looks for a value in the leftmost column of the table. Sorry. Here the limitation is topmost row of the table. Then HLOOKUP will not work. Is not in the top row, topmost row. But in the down, but in the below, then HLOOKUP will not work. So always look into the leftmost. Duplicate values in the topmost row. HLOOKUP considers only the first column. Only the first value. Okay, now we'll see the okay. Now let me write the transpose. Transpose function does what? Transpose converts vertical data to horizontal and horizontal to vertical. That means we have two things in the transpose. Transpose feature and transpose function. Transpose feature in paste special, which is not dynamic. Transpose function is dynamic. If user using less than Office 365 version, then transpose function must be executed as an array function. Let me tell you how transpose quickly works. Let's say, for example, 10, 20, 30 is there. When I am trying to take a formula equal to, okay, A equal to A43 colon A45, then if I decode, can you tell me what will happen? If I decode 10 semicolon 20 semicolon 30. I hope you all understood this. I covered while I was talking about the arrays. But when I put the same thing in the transpose, okay, transpose of A 43 colon A 48, 45, you know then what will happen? Can anyone tell? Simple. Equal to flower bracket 10 comma 20 comma 30. So what transpose is doing? Transpose is changing semicolon to comma and comma to semicolon. In Excel arrays, comma means next column, semicolon means next row. Now let us look into the other different functions. Friends, to overcome the limitations of the VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP functions, you know, still I can use. Now let me take the same data. Now for this data, let me give V table 2. Okay. Now when I'm trying to, okay, now V table 2 is the data. Now what I do? Let me remove that defined name. How to remove the defined name? Let's go here, name manager. I don't want V table, so I'll give the different name. What I'll do now, I'll take product ID as the last column. Okay, I'll take the product ID as the last column, right? Now, for example, I want to get the now result of the same thing. Now I want to get the result of VLOOKUP. Try to understand. Okay. Now I want to get this result. This is what my data is. Now let me give this data name as V table 2. Okay. Now let's look into the VLOOKUP. Can we solve this? First of all, I doubt. Let's look into this. VLOOKUP, look for this value. Where? V table 2. And get second column value or third column value. Subcategory is the second column, 2 comma 0. Excel will give you the result what? Can anyone tell what is the answer in this case? Can you all tell me the answer in this case? The answer is not available error. Why? As I told you, VLOOKUP looks for this value always in the leftmost column. Okay, but is there this value in the leftmost column here? No. That's the reason you copy paste everywhere it is not available. That is the problem with the VLOOKUP function. Now, if I want to get this value, VLOOKUP, look for this value where V table 2 and get the first column value as an answer. Whatever it is, your answer is wrong because leftmost column is not the value which I am looking for. This is the limitation of the VLOOKUP function. That's the reason there is a great function names XLOOKUP introduced in Office 365 Insider version. Now, then what is an alternative for this? Okay, there is a limitation, that's fine. But how to overcome this limitation? Can we use index and match in this case? Friends, can we use index and match? Yes. Now, you tell me what is the formula I should write? I already told you what type of formula we should use. What formula we should write to get the product subcategory by using index and match? I covered yesterday and day before yesterday elaborately the index and match. See, first of all, index function results you a value. Yes or no? A value in an array. That means that array is nothing but your first column. So simple, equal to index. Now, subcategory. Now you go here. This is what my array. Yes or no? Now this array. Now let me put F4 so that dollars will come, because if I copy paste, that column should not change. Because why I have selected this column? Because out of this column only I want to get a result, comma. Now row number. Do you have a direct row number in this array? No. For which generally we need to use the match function, because match function give you the position number. Now I'll use match function. What do you want to match? This value. Where you want to match? In this. Try to understand, please. Okay. Now close bracket. Friends, how many arguments are there in this table? Yeah, dollar symbols here also required. Okay. F4 is the shortcut. F4, I have used the shortcut F4. I've just selected this and I just clicked F4. Now, try to understand. How many arguments are there in the index function? 3. What are they? In which area you are looking for, and get me the result. In that area, what is a row number? What is a column number? Now, in this case, I've selected only one column. I want to get the result from this column, comma. What is a row number? Do you have a direct answer? No. That's the reason I am using match function. Match this value where in this column and which is an exact match, comma, 0. Close bracket. Right? Now, what is a column number? Not required in this case. If you observe, column number is optional. Why? Because you can find the square bracket for the column number. Why it is optional here? In this case, I need not to enter, because anyway in the array, I have selected only one column. If I ignore the column number, by default, it assumes that it is only one column. Okay. Now, can I enter? Do you think you will get the correct answer? Absolutely. Copy and paste. Right. Now, let us look into the product category. Now, can you tell me what formula I should write, please? By looking into this formula. Okay, please put in the chat box quickly. Can you please put in the chat box? What formula we write here to get the result? Okay, let me write the formula. Equal to index. Index will give you a result value. From which table? From this array. This time, because it's a product category, comma. Now let me give the dollar symbol for this. So select this and put F4 is the shortcut. Same as previous, only column will change. Wonderful. Now match. Match will be exactly same. Again, look for this column. Now, sorry, look, first value is lookup value. Look for this value in this column and get me the exact match. Close bracket, close bracket. Now, see, match is not changing if you observe. Copy, paste, absolutely. Now, friends, what I'll be doing just for the practice purpose. Control C, or else we'll take the same data. Let's copy this. Paste special transpose, delete equal to transpose V table 2, close bracket, Control Shift, sorry, equal to transpose V table 2, close bracket, Control Shift Enter. Now this is actually the column. Let me keep here. Oh, this is an array. Copy paste special value. Now what I'm going to do, I'll cut this. Yeah, I think this is correct only. Yeah? All right. Now if I want to use hlookup function, control C. By using this data, is it possible? No. Why? Because the value I'm looking for this, let me give a defined name as H table 2. Now, what is the formula I should write equal to? H lookup. Look for this value where H table 2. In this, I want to get second column, second row value as an answer, which is an exact match. Okay, my answer is not available error. Why? Because the answer, all the value which I am looking for must be always into the top row, this row, not okay, below row. Same thing, equal to H lookup. Look for this value where H table 2 and get the first column value as a result. You'll not get your answer because the value you are looking for not in that table, right? Now, the same thing can we solve by using index and match? Yes, I think yes. How? Now you tell me, please, at least this one. Please put in the chat box what formula we write. Everyone. It's very simple, equal to index. Now, product subcategory is not in the column, it is in the row. Now I'll select this entire row, give the dollars, comma. Now, in this row, what is the column number? Row number 0, because only one row is there. Whether you keep it or not, no problem. Okay. Now, or else you can keep one, because anyway one row is there. Now, column number. Column number. Now, I'm writing a function match. What value you are looking for? This. Where you are looking for? In this table. And give the dollars. Exact match, close bracket. Now, see, earlier case, I ignored the column number because column number is optional, because only one column is there. I need not to tell to Excel from which column it has to pick up. Now, row number is not optional. So I entered one. That means because I only selected one row, take from that row. Okay. Then even you can take zero also, because zero means all rows. Only one row is there. So column, to get the column number, I have written a match function. Now enter. Absolutely correct. Now in this case, HLOOKUP, look for this, sorry, index, get the values in this. What is the row number? 1. What is the column number? Use the match function. Match this value where in this table, get the exact match 0. Absolutely. Copy and paste. Now there is a question from Vinat. You have put 3 close bracket. Why? No, only 2. Here 2, right? One is for the match function, one is for the index function. Because match is part of the index function. Got it, Vinat? I kept only 2 brackets. In this case also it's 2. Everywhere 2. If you see, even here also it is 2. It's not, okay, it's not 3. Fine. So, to overcome VLOOKUP function limitation, and HLOOKUP limitation of the leftmost column or top most row, we can use index and match. Friends, outside people may think that index and match is little tough to understand, but that's a myth actually. Index and match is very simple, but you need to understand the logic where you need to use. Till here, if anyone having any question, please let me know. But people hesitate to use index and match, but because they, you know, out of all the Excel users, 80% of the Excel users knows the VLOOKUP function, because VLOOKUP is such a dynamic function. Most of the people know. Whenever there is a limitation, people ignore it. Now, what I'm going to do? We'll take these all our case studies. Now, these all are remarks. What is this? Okay, this is multi-column. Okay. Now, what I'll do, without using index and match, using VLOOKUP only, how to solve to overcome the limitation. I hope you all are getting my point. Now, next 15 to 20 minutes, the topic is very important. Anyway, index and match is the solution, fine. But without going into index and match, can't I solve by using just the VLOOKUP function itself? Concentrate. That concept, I call it as the reverse lookup. Okay. Now let's say a student is there, ID is there. Student A, B, ID. Okay, I need to get. Now, for example, there's a master data. Student B, student A, student B ID is 2, student A ID is 1. Now, let's say this is there into the center alignment. Now, if I want to get the value here, simple, we look up, look for this value where within this call, within this data, get the second column value as an answer. Wow. This is, there is no problem. We all know it. For example, if the master data is like this, okay, then what I need to do? Can I write the VLOOKUP function? No, equal to VLOOKUP. Look for this value where, within this table, get the second column value, sorry, first column value as an answer. No, why? Because the value which I am looking for is not in the leftmost column of the table. Now, if you observe clearly, this formula and this formula, which is creating the problem? In the second case, okay, do you interchange the column data? Means, okay, how I converted this data into this data? Simple. See, Control X, go here. Once you right click, you can find an option, insert cut cells. Once you click it, you'll get this. Again, I'm doing Control X, go here, right click, insert cut cells. But insert cut cells will not find in every system that is based on, again, the settings. Okay. So BOS settings at the back end, based on that, it will come. Now, okay, let's come back to our question. So in this case, if I want to get the first column, so I'm looking for this table. In this table, I'm not finding the answer. So it's a not available error. It's not there in 2019. No, insert cut cells is there since so many years, but you need to cut it first of all to get that option. Even after Control X, you are not finding that option. That means, okay, at the back end, the settings of your hardware, we should change. Yeah, it's there. Great. See, okay. Now, friends, now let's come back to this important session. Now, let me write the formula text so that you can understand. Okay. Out of about two functions, which is creating the problem? Here four arguments are there. I got an error. Okay. So, which argument is creating the problem in this case? Can anyone tell? Do you think first argument is creating the problem? No. Irrespective of the case, whether it is leftmost column or right side, first argument will not change. Do you think second argument is creating the problem? Maybe. Because Third argument is also depending on the second argument. Do you think fourth argument is creating the problem? No, because if it is an exact match, 0, otherwise 1. It is nowhere relating to my data. So out of all the four arguments, second argument is creating the problem. If I can repair the second argument, I think I'll get my answer. Try to understand carefully. Now, in this case, if I decode this, if I put F9, can you tell me how my data will look like? It will decode this entire B2A1. So how it appears in the flower bracket, B, 2, semicolon, A, 1. I hope everyone understood the meaning of this. The meaning of this is nothing but this. Do you agree with me? Yes. The meaning of this table is exactly like this. Now, what is the repair which I'm going to do is nothing but I'll do a repair in such a way so that, one sec, my second array must convert into the first array. Please have a look. Now, what is my job? My job is very simple. I'll write a formula in such a way so that this array will be converted into this array. How you are understanding this array? B, A in the first column, 2, 1 in the second column. In this array, 2, 1 in the first column, B, A in the second column. I hope you get my point. So, just because the limitation, the value which I am looking for is not in the leftmost column of the table, why should I abandon the VLOOKUP function? If I can repair the VLOOKUP function in such a way so that I can still use the VLOOKUP function, maybe with the combination of the other function, I can get the solution for this. To do that, first I need to identify which argument is creating the problem. I identified that this is the argument which is creating the problem. Now, instead of second argument of the VLOOKUP function, I'll write other function. Okay, now let me introduce you one small function in Excel named choose. Have you heard this function earlier? No. Fine. So let's say one is there. What this choose function does, choose, what is the first argument? Index number. I want first value. Out of the values you enter, if you observe value 1, value 2, value 3, and so on, ... is there. That means you can put n number of values here, A, B, just for the example, C, D, E, F, you can put n number, G, H, that's all. Friends, how many arguments I entered? I entered 9 arguments. First argument is index number, second argument is first value, third argument is second value, fourth argument is third value, fifth argument is fourth value, and so on. Then, ninth argument is, eighth value, right? Now, if I enter, what this choose function does, out of these 8 values, which value I want to get, I can put as a first one. Index number is 1, so I want to get first value A. If I put 2, second value, 3, third value, 4, fourth value, 8, eighth value. That's the beauty of the choose function. If anyone having any question, please let me know. Don't worry. Independently, if you see this function, as I told you, you cannot understand anything. We are going to use this as the supporting function. Okay, this is the formula, this is the result. If anyone having any question on this, please let me know. No, right? Great. Now this is the choose function. We all know it. Now let me just move it down. Now friends, I'll write a small formula in the choose category. Please let me know what is the answer. Equal to choose 1, can you all tell me what is the meaning of this 1, 1, means out of the values I enter, please pick up the first value. Yes or no? Yes. First value is this, comma, second value is this. Don't confuse. Now, instead of one, earlier example, I have taken A, I have taken B, only one value. Now, instead of one value, I have taken a range. Instead of second value, I have taken one more range. Out of these two, can you tell me what is my first value? Value one is this. So if I enter, can anyone tell, can anyone guess what is my answer? In the chat box, can you please keep it? If I enter, what is my answer? If I enter this function, choose formula, what is my answer? How come A, in this case, E6 colon E7 is first value, second value is D6 colon D7. Now, I said Excel to get the first value. So, if I enter, I should get E6 colon E7. But E6 colon E7 is a 2 by 1 matrix. I am writing the formula where 1 by 1 matrix. Is it possible to fit 2 by 1 matrix into 1 by 1 matrix? Not possible. So I'll get a value error. Whatever the answer you informed is wrong. Value error because my first value is not one value. It is having 2 by 1 matrix. How can I fit 2 by 1 matrix into one single cell? It may be value error at the back end. Okay. But if I select this and put F9. If I put F9, can you tell me what's the answer? Maybe if I enter, it's a value error. I know because I cannot fit 2 by 1 matrix into one single cell. But if I put F9, simple. The result at the back end is B6, E6 colon E7. So I'll get B semicolon A. Let me put F9. The answer for this is this. If anyone having any question, please let me know. Now, can you tell me what is the answer? Choose 2, comma, this, comma, this, close bracket. Don't confuse, please. Now, if I enter, can you tell me what is the answer? What may be the answer? Again, value error, because I want to get second column value as a result. I'm sorry. I want to get second column value as a result. So 2 is second column, second value. So second value is having n range again. It's a 2 by 1 matrix. Can I fit 2 by 1 matrix into one single cell? No. If you enter again, you will get a value error. But if I decode, can you tell me what's my answer? My answer is 2 semicolon 1. So for this, my answer is 2 semicolon 1. Sorry. Flower bracket 2 comma semicolon 1. If anyone having any question, why these two are the answers at the back end, can you have a question, please let me know. Friends, don't confuse. I did not enter exclusively this because if I enter, I may get value error. That's the reason I'm just trying to show you at the back end how it is understanding. Right? Now, the climax. Now, what I'll be doing, I'll write one more formula equal to choose 1, comma, this, comma, this. You may be asking, Sharon, the same question you asked here. So obviously it's a value error because my answer is E6 colon E7 enter. E6 colon E7 is a 2 by 1 matrix. Now what I'm trying to tell to Excel, I don't want to tell to Excel it has to work one time. I told you, instead of 1, now what I'm going to keep? 1, comma, 2. Don't confuse. See, now my index number, I am expecting Excel to calculate choose function 2 times. First time take 1 as a index number, second time take 2 as an index number, right? So if first time it take 1 as an index number, E6 colon E7 is the answer. Second time when it takes 2 as an index number, D6 colon D7 is the answer. But what I am trying to tell to Excel, both it has to work. Do you remember in the SUMIFS function, after the arrays concept I have covered, in the SUMIFS function, the alternative we have written array formula of sum function, in that, in the case of year function I have written even the month function, I have written even the text function also. Instead of one serial number in the year function and text function, I have given the entire date column. That means I am expecting my year function to work 499 times. I hope everyone remember that concept. Exactly same concept I am trying to apply here. Here I want to apply my choose function to work 2 times. First time take first column, second time take second column. Both you keep one after other. How do Excel know that? It has to keep in an array one after other because I kept comma. If you keep semicolon, E6 colon E7, then D6 colon D7, one below other will come. Because I kept comma, E6 colon E7 will come in the first column, D6 colon D7 will come in the second column. If I select everything and put F9, now it became a 2x2 matrix. Control C. But friends, if I enter, what is my answer in this formula? Again, value error, because this will give you the result of 2x2 matrix. You are trying to write the formula in 1x1 matrix, so it's not possible. Don't confuse. Instead of this, even other way around also I can write. How? Choose 2, 1, then take this, comma, take this. Friends, do you think this value will change with above value? My question is, will you get a different answer if I decode? Do you think I'll get a different value if I decode? Why there is a confusion? Earlier, I want to extract the first value, that is E6 colon E7, then second value, that is D6 colon E7. Now I am trying to tell to Excel, extract the second value, that means E6 colon E7, keep it into the first column, then extract the first value, D6 colon D7, keep it into the second column. Both will give you exactly the same answer. Control C, Control V. Friends, is this nothing but this one? So instead of second argument of the VLOOKUP function, if I can write a choose function, what choose function does, it reshuffle the columns inside. It interchange the columns inside in the formula itself. I think my problem was solved. Yes. Now instead of this, let me put the choose function. Everyone please have a look. Equal to VLOOKUP. Look for this value where choose 1, 2. Can you tell me what must be my first column? My first column must be always the values in which my answer is there. One sec. My first column is the column in which my answers are there. So this is what my first column. Comma. What is my second column? This is what my second column. Close bracket. Friends, I did nothing. I have taken here the VLOOKUP function. First argument, this entirely is the second argument. Table array, this is the lookup value. Now table array. Now in this table, in which column your answer is there, second column, get the exact match. Do you think I'll get my answer? Absolutely. Okay. So, if you know the choose function, maybe, because you all are seeing for the first time, these all are little above concepts. Okay. You may be little confusing, but once you start practicing, you will get to know. There is no doubt. Okay. Don't confuse. Just go with the rules. How I am covering one after other, piece by piece. Once you go into the rules, you can understand. This is a small maths. In our school days, whatever the maths we learned, exactly the same maths. Nothing more, nothing less. Here, I'm using choose function because choose function can extract both the columns separately. To make it join, I used a small array inside the choose function. That's all. Otherwise, choose function has given me, it has broken the table into two columns. First column, second column. But I don't want it has to be as a separate columns, but I want to get it as a single table. So I'm joining those two columns by using array, right? Friends, if you clearly observe, this can be even solved by using if function also. A very simple if function also can done this job. It seems easy, but applying combination is logical and not easy. Yeah, it looks easy, but it's not easy, I know. But as I told you, very important thing here you need to understand are the basics. Okay, these all how the operations are working. Maybe for the first time, you may find little tough, but later if you start working on the paper, I'm sure you can get the result. Now, this can be absolutely done with if function also. You may be surprising how if function can do. Let's work. Friends, equal to if a comma 10 comma 20. Can you tell me what's my answer? Can you tell me what is my answer in this case? Put in the chat box. Can you all keep it in the chat box? What is my answer? By this time, you must be good with the logics and basics. Why you are taking a lot of time? Friends, in this case, my first argument of the VLOOKUP function is a logical test. But I am entering a text, normal text. It is asking for a logical test. Logical test always results you what? Either true or false. Either you can enter true or false, or you can enter a logical test so that Excel will calculate and get the true and false. But what I am trying to enter? Text. That means, is it an invalid argument? Yes. In case of invalid argument, what is my answer value? Don't confuse. For example, equal to if 10 greater than 5 comma 10 comma 20. What's my answer? Put in the chat box. I request let the class be more interactive. 10 greater than 5 comma 10 comma 20. Absolutely. Right? Why? 10 greater than 5. It's a true. 10, 20. So true value here is 10. So my answer is 10. For example, equal to if true comma 10 comma 20. What's my answer? Put in the chat box. Absolutely. Why? Either you can give a logical test. Even you give the logical test, Excel will convert it into true or false. So I directly have given true or false. My answer is still 10. For example, equal to if 1 comma 10 comma 20. What is my answer? Can you tell me what is the answer in this case? Absolutely. True can be considered as 1 in the case of if function. So my answer is 10. Because 1 may be true. Equal to if 0 comma 10 comma 20. What's my answer? 0 can be considered as a false. My answer is 20. Right? Now, equal to if 10 greater than 5, can you tell me what may be the answer? In this case, my Excel worked 2 times. First time it take true value, second time it takes false value. True value is, what is the answer? 10. False value is 20. So I'm having two answers now. How to arrange those two answers? I kept comma. So that means one after other. If you enter, you may get value error. But if you decode, if I decode, what is my answer? I'm sorry. 10, 20. 10, comma 20. Check it out. This is what you will get in case if you decode this formula. Okay. Now, for example, this is in fact equal to, if in flat bracket 10 comma 1 comma 20 comma 30, 20 comma 10. Do you think this will give you a different answer? No. Now 0 means false value, which is 10, comma 1 means true value, which is 20. So Excel is doing two operations. Each operation will give you separate answer. But those two answers, I should keep it into some table, right? So what is an indication? I kept a comma, so those two answers will come one after other exactly the same. Don't confuse. F9, I'm sorry. Why? So 10 comma 20. I'm sorry. This is not a flower bracket. This is normal bracket. Yeah. So if you decode, you will get the result. Sorry. Let me select this properly. Yeah. From here till here, if I decode, I'll get F9. This is 1020. Absolutely the same answer. Don't confuse. Okay. Now, can you tell me what will happen for in this case? Equal to F in flower bracket 10 semicolon 20 comma, sorry, 1 semicolon 2 comma 10 comma 20. If I decode, what is my answer? Put in the chat box. Sorry, it's not 2, it's 0. It's not flower bracket, it is normal bracket. Now can you put the answer in the chat box? In this case, it takes first true value, second false value. But how those two values will arrange one below other? Now my answer is 10 semicolon 20. Because I kept a semicolon here. So in this case, my answer is this. But for example, if 0 semicolon 1 comma 20 comma 10, do you think my answer differs? My answer will not differ. It is exactly the same. If I select this F9, now it is semicolon because this is a semicolon here. So this answer is, I think it's a semicolon here. Exactly the same answer. Try to understand. In the case of choose function, because I want my both the columns must come one after other in a table, I have used the comma. Because this is a VLOOKUP function. In case of HLOOKUP function, I will write semicolon. Why? Because my rows must come one below other. Friends, I'll just show you these formulas. Just for 2 minutes, have a glance. You must understand these things very carefully. So I'm just showing you all these formulas. Just in 2 minutes, have a glance. Okay. These if functions. Okay, friends. Let us go ahead. So now, the same thing, let's say if my data is like this, this can be solved in many methods. This is master data. If we need to get the answer, just VLOOKUP. VLOOKUP only, you will not get the answer. Why? Because the value which we are looking for is not in the leftmost column of the table. Okay. Now, can we solve the same thing by using Index and match can be solved by using index and match. Yes, you'll get the answer. Have a look. How to solve by using index and match? Equal to index out of this column values I want to get as a result, comma, match my row number, look for this value where, oh sorry, I need to get the array, right? So this is what my index. Now I need to look for A38 in this. Now in this I am looking for exact match. Column number, am I need to mention here? No, because only one column is there. That's all. Through index and match, I can solve. I can even solve by using VLOOKUP and choose. How? Simple. Same thing. Equal to VLOOKUP. Look for this value. Where? Choose 1, 2, comma. Now, what is my first column? My first column must be this, comma. What must be my second column? My second column must be this. Is it correct? Yes. So this is my second column. This is my first column, comma. Now close bracket, because your choose function is over. Out of these two columns, in which column your answer is? My answer is there in the second column, comma 2, comma 0. Do you think I'll get my answer? Absolutely. This can be even solved by using VLOOKUP and IF function also. Just now I told you, right? IF also can solve. What I need to do? Now I need to simply keep, instead of choose, if, instead of 1, 2, 1, 0. Because now this is the true value. This is the false value. One after other, I'm going to keep here. Just copy paste. That's all. So wherever we have a limitation of the left column, our index and match can solve, our VLOOKUP and choose can solve, or else VLOOKUP and IF function can solve. Why I prefer to use the choose function, you know, because tomorrow there may be a situation where you need to join three columns, maybe for some other purpose. Then even I can keep 1, 2, 3 also. But in the case of IF function, it will never go beyond 1, 0 or 0, 1. Why? Because maximum two values only allowed. If it is true, if it is false. That's the reason. If you want to build a table by adding so many columns together, the best one is choose than the IF. But if you think only two columns you want to join, the best one is IF function. Okay, if you think these all are a little complicated, index and match is simplest, right? Now, very quickly, let us take the same master data and we will make it vertical as a horizontal, horizontal as a vertical. Okay, let us transpose this data, right? Transpose this data. Now, vertical became horizontal, horizontal became vertical, right? Now, this is what the student and this is what the ID. Now, I cannot solve. Now, I'm not going to give the answers at all. I want you to solve this by just looking into the data. Now, HLOOKUP only if you try to do, you will get your wrong answers. Why? Because the value which I am looking must be into the top row. But is it in the top row? No. Then my answer is wrong. Can I solve the same thing by using index and match? Of course. How can I solve? Equal to index. My answer is there in this row. Okay. Now, what is the row number? Anyway, one row, one, you can take it. What is the column number? That is the position of this value where in this row, get me the exact answer. Close bracket, absolutely. Now, Can I solve the same thing by using H lookup and choose? Yes. So instead of V, H lookup. How to do this? Simple. Equal to H lookup. Look for this value. Choose. Now what I need to do? It should not be 1, comma 2. It should be 1 semicolon 2 because I'm going to keep everything one after other. Now I'll be just going here. Now let me go here. Now what is my first row? I want always my first row this. What is my second row? I want always my second row must be this. Now close bracket. Now this will give you a 2x2 matrix again. First row is nothing but the values. Okay, student name is there. Second row is nothing but the IDs are there. In this table, which row you want to get as an answer? Second row as an answer. Exactly. Copy and paste. This can be even done by using HLOOKUP and IF function also. How it will change? The only place it will change is instead of choose, put F. Instead of 1 comma semicolon 2, put 1 comma 0. That's all. Copy paste. Okay. So if you know the logics, you can solve the things n number of ways. Friends, this is to solve my one limitation only. In fact, I'm having how many limitations? 2 limitations. If I use any of the index and match or maybe VLOOKUP and choose or VLOOKUP and hit if function, probably I may solve only the first limitation. But there is one more limitation. What is that limitation? The value, if two values are there, it always pick up the first value. It will not pick up the second value automatically. Okay. So if that is the case, my question is how to solve the second limitation, how to overcome the second limitation. Now let me take the example for that. Instance related. Okay. Now for this, let me take an example. Name is there, amount is there, A, B, A, C, B, A, C, sorry, B, A, C, D, B, A, D, C. There are so many names are there. Now equal to random between. I'm just taking some random numbers. Copy paste special values. Now this is the name, this is the amount. Okay, so I'll take their name and their data validation, A comma B comma C comma D. I'll also take the instance. I'll take 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4 because I can find 1, 2, 3, 4 times maximum an item is coming. Now, this is an assignment for all of you. Okay. For tomorrow. What is this assignment? Is you can use supporting columns, no problem. Based on my selection, I should get my answer. Directly, if you use a VLOOKUP function equal to VLOOKUP, look for this value where within this table, get me the second column value as an answer. See, first time it is coming, 998 will come. If I put 2, again 998. Because as I told you, VLOOKUP function is having a limitation. It always look into the first column of the table and also first value in the range. If, for example, I want to get fourth time wherever it is coming. Fourth time where it is coming, 1, 2, 3, 4th time. 690 must be my answer. But it always pick up the first one. Now, this is an assignment for you for tomorrow. So I want everyone to seriously work on this. You can use the number of supporting columns. You can use, do whatever you want. I want the solution here. Okay. What method do you follow to get the answer? You cannot use index and match. why index is having the limitation, match is also having the same limitation. If you have more than one value, match function always takes the first value in the range. Okay, so you cannot solve this by using index and match. You cannot even by using VLOOKUP and choose, because choose function is only to transform your column, second column as a first column, first as a second column, interchange your column. It cannot work in this case. So use a method through which we should solve this. Okay, that is about I think elaborately most of the case studies are covered with respect to the VLOOKUP function, HLOOKUP function, and so on. But we did not cover this instance when we are going to use the approximate match. We'll take that example and we'll close the session. Approximate match, right? Generally, where we use, you know, for example, name is there, or then you can put n number of names. Yeah, I'll cover A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L. Like that, names are there. So many names are there, right? I'm having due days are there. Due days means these all are, let's say, debtors. They need to pay, you know, and it's pending these many days. Equal to random between, let's say, 32. 25 to, let's say, 380. Let it be. Now I want to get the aging. Okay, normally for aging, range, this is what the aging. 0 to 30 days, we call it as less than 1 month. 31 to 90 days, less than 3 months. 91 to 180 days, less than 6 months. 181 to 365, less than 1 year. And 365 and above, greater than 1 year. If you don't have a VLOOKUP function, you know how people may solve this? They use which function? If function. If look for this value, okay, check it out whether it is less than 30, less than or equal to 30. If as, please display less than 1 month. If not, again put if function, check it out whether this value is less than or equal to 91. Okay, 90. If as, then please display less than 3 months. And again, if, check it out whether this value is less than or equal to 180 days. 180. If as, then put less than 6 months. If not, again, check it out. If, check it out, this value is less than or equal to 365 days. If as, then please put 1 year. If not, that means it is greater than 365, that means put greater than 1 year. Close the last if function, close before that, close this one. Manual, very manual, right? If you have so many ranges, you need to put so many functions. This is hectic and very difficult to digest this formula. So thanks to VLOOKUP, equal to VLOOKUP, it looks for this value where in this array I need to get now which column values. I'm having three columns, 1, 2, 3. Third column value, if you say exact match, nowhere you will get the answers. Why? Because none of this value is matching here, right? So I should go for approximate match. If it is in the case of approximate match, there's an extra rule. Approximate match. The values in the first column of the table must be sorted in the ascending order. That means either you can ignore the fourth argument or you can enter one. That's an approximate match. But the rule is, Sharon, if you want to use the approximate match, make sure that your left column values must be sorted in the ascending order. Now, enter. Do you think this turtle is exactly in the ascending order? Yes. That's the reason it's working. If these are like, okay, this is the first column, first row, then this is the second row, then this is third row, then this is fourth row, then this is fifth row. If the arrangement is in such a way, our VLOOKUP function approximate match will not work, because approximate match rule of approximate match is that the left column of the table must be sorted in the ascending order. Okay, that is what the rule. So you must be very careful. Oh, I think it is less than 1 year. I have to take care. Okay, so I hope everyone understood the approximate match. It's very simple. Okay, what Excel is doing, if you observe here, in fact, second column is not having any relevance. Even you remove the second column, okay, your approximate match will work, because then you need to take 2 years. Okay, then you remove the second column, it will work. This column is just to understand that 0 to 30 is this. If you remove this column, it is by default below 31, above 1 is 1 month, above 31, below 91 is 3 months, and so on. This is just to understand. Okay, so that's the way the approximate match works. If anyone having any question, please let me know. But you must be very careful with respect to the rule. If, for example, the data is there in the vertical shape, horizontal shape, then I'm going to use the same thing. This is VLOOKUP, and this is HLOOKUP. What is the formula? Equal to HLOOKUP. Look for this value where within this table, and get me the get me the third row values. If you put exact match, nothing will match, because if you put exact, it has to exactly match. Now what I need to do, I should either put one or you remove. In this case also, the first row of the table must be always sorted in the ascending order. So many rules are there. Okay, there's a simple approximate match. If anyone having any question, please let me know. Okay, even I can cover a small example in the case of approximate match. For example, if my data is like this, I'm sorry. Okay, friends, if my data is like this, for example, I want to refer this data, how to solve? Index and match. This is an assignment for you, and I want you to solve by using VLOOKUP and choose. Anyway, tomorrow I'll give the answers for this, and I want you should solve by using VLOOKUP and if. Okay, this is what your data must be. Consider this data, and you cannot directly put a VLOOKUP function, because the value you are looking for is not in the leftmost column of the table. So you must be very careful. So by using these three functions, how are you going to solve? Okay, these three are the assignments, and this also the assignment. Okay, now let's come back to the important. I think I've covered almost everything. Let me come to the last one, XLOOKUP. A great upgradation in Office 365. XLOOKUP introduced in September 2019, along with XLookup. XMatch also introduced. Okay, so what are the changes in the XLookup function? Advantages of XLookup. Need not to select the table. Instead, user should select lookup array and result array separately. Okay, this is one. Second one, I hope you are getting my point. Earlier days, we used to select the entire table and we used to give the column index number. Now column index number concept gone. Why? Because lookup array you select, what is the answer you want to get? Select only that column. Excel will know which column you are going to get it. So because of this, values need not to be in the leftmost column. Lookup value need not to be in the leftmost column. And one more. By default, it is exact match now. Why? Because what Excel thought, than using one, using zero as a fourth argument is okay 90% of the cases. So if that is the case, by default giving approximate match is not correct. So that's the reason it said from X in the XLookup function, by default it's an exact match. If you don't give the argument, by default it's an exact match. If not, that means you want to specifically mention approximate match, okay, then you have to give the argument. Now one more limitation, it is capable of even searching from bottom. There are two options. Do you want to search from top or bottom? This is advantage in case of duplicates. When you have two values, if you ask Excel to search from top, it takes the first value. If you ask Excel to search from the bottom, it takes the second value. But it is still the same issue is there. If more than two values are there, your VLOOKUP will not work. Limitations of VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP, almost limitations, except the instance number related. Okay, if you have more than one time, if it is appearing, even XLOOKUP cannot answer. Maximum two things. Okay, for example, now, yeah, these all are the things. Now let's go to the, it's not in 2019. It is again Office 365. Very soon it will roll up to all the Office 365 users. Now what we'll do, we'll take the same example. Okay. Sorry. Okay, so let's go here. XLookup case study. Now let's quickly work on this. Now query quickly, I'm looking for product subcategory equal to XLookup. Are you finding? Oh, even in my case it's not come. I'll do one thing. Okay, because mine is yet to update the insider version. What I'll do, mostly by today I'll update it and I'll explain tomorrow, but don't worry, I can just, but it has to come. One sec, just give me one sec. In the latest version, XLookup has to come. Okay, fine. Mine also not updated. Probably I'll be getting in next couple of, because the problem with the insider is even out of the insiders randomly they'll pick up. But I surprised, I used very recently, not this account. Okay, I'll try by tomorrow. I'll try to get XLOOKUP. If not, I'll change this account and I'll take some other account where XLOOKUP is there and I'll explain. Okay, but as an instance, if you want to just give me 2 minutes. Okay, XLOOKUP Microsoft Excel. Sorry, XLOOKUP, right? XLOOKUP. I only written a small snap of 10 points in my Facebook long back, not this. I want to directly go into the Excel. Yeah. Now check it out. This is the XLOOKUP. Now if you look into the arguments, I want to see the GAN. So where are the arguments? Yeah. No, X match alphabetical X. Where is the XLOOKUP? Yeah, XLOOKUP. I want to see the arguments. Yeah, syntax. Check it out. See, now your syntax is, now let me just cut it and paste this. You see what he said? We will continue to optimize it over to the next several months. When XLOOKUP is ready, we'll release it to all the Office insiders. Okay, so this is the syntax. Okay, Control C, Control V. Tomorrow I'll make sure that I'll get it. Whoever the system it's having, I'll try my level best. But I thought it's there in my account. Probably I was having a different Office account that time. Okay, now just check it out. Now if you look here, lookup value is nothing but the same thing what was there even earlier. Now lookup array, return array. Lookup array is, this lookup value is there in which column or which row? Now XLOOKUP, even over, now you need not to use two functions. XLOOKUP is for both, is replacement for both VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. Now you need not to use two functions. Why? Exactly. If you observe here, lookup array, return array. This can be either row or column. If you put a row here, that automatically look into the horizontal. If you put a column, that automatically become a vertical. If not found, this is very recently they updated, not even September month, in the recent Microsoft Ignite. Okay. MS Ignite XLOOKUP update. If you observe the update, what this did, you know, because many a cases when people are get, if the value it's not there, people are getting any error. In the case of any error, it is little irritating. Again, I have to take the support of some other function like a if error function. Now they introduced it just 1 week back. If the value is not found, what value you want to display? Either even you can ignore this. Simply you can put, if not available, any. Let me just look into this Ignite. XLOOKUP. Yeah, see. What is the update? XLOOKUP for Excel makes the spreadsheet search experience faster. And it. Okay, this just given the introduction. I'm just trying to see what other places they use. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now, in this update, okay, if you go a little in depth, you'll get to know what changes happened here. So, the new update is if it is not found. That means I don't want to get the NA error. If the value is not there, just put something like NA or not available or blank. You can put whatever you want. Match mode. Match mode is basically, it is like exact match, approximate match and so on. By default, it is exact match. Search mode. Do you want to search from top to bottom or bottom to top? If this is capable of searching both the sides, that is what the XLOOKUP. Okay, I'll try to get it tomorrow. We'll see the answer for this. And friends, I've given you a couple of assignments even today. This one you have to solve, and this one you can easily write. And yesterday assignment is still unanswered. Okay, I request you to again look for today and try to solve the yesterday's assignment. Okay, so again, the material may not come. I don't know the technical reason. Even I sent an email, I'll send the material through WhatsApp. That's all for today. If anyone having any question, please let me know. I think I've covered VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP very elaborate, and including with limitations and how to overcome, including the reverse lookup and approximate match. Guys, that's all for today. If you have